गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो वी आर डूइंग चैप्टर 5 ऑफ एनसीईआरटी, दैट इज फंडामेंटल यूनिट ऑफ लाइफ. एंड इन दिस वी आर डूइंग द टॉपिक सेल ऑर्गेनेलीज. सो इन सेल ऑर्गेनेलीज, नाउ नेक्स्ट सेल ऑर्गेनेली इज लाइजोसोम्स. सो दीज आर मेम्ब्रेन बाउंड सैक्स फिल्ड विद डाइजेस्टिव एंजाइम्स विच आर मेड बाय RER. RER is rough endoplasmic reticulum. So these are basically sphere-like structures filled with digestive enzymes. So lysosomes are a kind of waste disposal system of the cell. So to dispose of the waste from the cell, lysosomes are helpful. Now third point is, it helps to keep the cell clean by digesting any foreign material as well as worn out cell organelles. It can also make cell clean by digesting any foreign material. Foreign material means anything which can come from outside to the cell, as well as any worn out cell organelles. May if any cell organelle may get rupture up or become worn out, so it will keep the cell clean by digesting them. Then lysosomes are able to do this because they contain powerful digestive enzymes capable of breaking down all organic material. They are having their digestive juices, their material filled with digestive enzymes which can help in breaking down all the organic material. So when the cell gets damaged, lysosomes may burst and the enzymes digest their own cell. If something wrong has happened to cell, its functioning may get stopped. So lysosomes may burst and will eat up their own cell. Means they will eat their own cell. Therefore, these are also known as suicide bags of the cell. Now here comes the next cell organelle, mitochondria. As you all very well know, what is mitochondria? These are known as the powerhouses of the cell, means that will provide energy to the cell. And it is also having two membrane covering, means it is also double layered or double membrane like structure. The outer membrane is porous, means having pores, while the inner membrane is deeply folded, as you can see in the structure or a picture given aside. See, two membranes are there. The outer one is having pores, that is written porins, and the inner one is folded, deeply folded. Then the energy required for various chemical activities needed for life is released by the mitochondria in the form of ATP molecules. In which form the mitochondria will give energy? In the form of ATP molecules. What are ATP? ATP is adenosine triphosphate, which is also known as energy currency of the cell. So mitochondria will provide energy to the cell in the form of ATP. And mitochondria have their own DNA and ribosomes. It is the first cell organelle which is having their own DNA and ribosome. Therefore, they are able to make some of their own proteins. Otherwise, other cell organelles do not have their own DNA and ribosomes. So mitochondria and one other cell organelle is having DNA and ribosome. so they can make able to make their own proteins. You can see in the picture now, double membrane structure, ATP are also shown there. It is located on the inside folded membrane. Then the DNA and the mitochondrial DNA is also shown here, so which is responsible for making their own proteins. Next we have to study plastids. It is another type of cell organelle. These are basically present only in plant cells. There are no plastids in animal cells. So one differentiation between plant cell and animal cell. Plant cells are having plastids, but animal cells do not have plastids. Then these are of two types. First, chromoplast. Chromo refers to colored plastids. Then leucoplast, white or colorless plastids. So two types of plastids, colored plastids and white or colorless plastids. First, chromoplast. What are chromoplast? These are containing the pigment chlorophyll, are known as chloroplast, which is important for photosynthesis in plants. As you all know, the plants are having chlorophyll in them. That's why they are having green color. So that green color may come from the chlorophyll, and a chlorophyll is present in the chromoplast, which are green colored plastids. And in leucoplast, materials like starch, oils and protein granules are stored. So these are colorless plastids. You can see in the picture, chloroplast is shown to you. It is green in color. Chromoplast, these are colored plastids. And then leucoplast. Leucoplast is again of two types. First, amyloplast, they are having starch in it. Elaioplast, they are having oils. And proteinoplast, they are having protein granules in them. These are similar to mitochondria in external structure and also have their own DNA and ribosomes. Means these are also double membrane like structures, and they are having same structure as that of the mitochondria, similar structure, and also have their own DNA and ribosomes. So two cell organelles are there which is having their own DNA and ribosomes. So these are capable of making their own proteins. Next cell organelle is vacuoles. Now what are these vacuoles? These are the storage sacs for solid or liquid contents. They can store both solids as well as liquid. Vacuoles are small sized in animal cells, while plant cells have very large vacuoles. See the picture given. An animal cell, one animal is cell is showing to you, and when plant cell is shown to you. So in animal cell there are smaller vacuoles and they are several in number, whereas in plant cell there is one big vacuole present towards the cell membrane. So these vacuoles are full of cell sap and provide turgidity and rigidity to the cell. Basically these vacuoles are full of cell sap and they will make the cell turgid or rigid. It occupies 50 to 90% of the cell volume. So the entire cell volume, almost entire cell volume is based upon that vacuoles. Vacuoles include amino acids, sugars, various organic acids and some proteins. So what are inside these vacuoles? They are having amino acids, sugars, various organic acids and some proteins. They can contain both solid and liquid contents. In animal cell, they can use for storage, and plant cells also used to store water and push against the cell wall. In plant cell they are against the cell wall and keeps the plant rigid. Now we all understood that a typical or a basic cell is made up of three components: cell membrane or plasma membrane, nucleus and cytoplasm. And this cytoplasm is having various cell organelles in it, which is to perform their specific functions. Then our last topic of this chapter is cell division. As from the name, it is very much clear that division of the cell. So new cells formed in organisms in order to grow, to replace the old, dead and injured cells and to form gametes for reproduction. In all that cases, the cell has to divide itself. So the process by which new cells are made is called cell division. It is the simple definition. The process by which new cells are made is called cell division, and it can occur in two ways. First, mitosis, and second is meiosis. So what will happen in mitosis? Each cell called mother cell. So the cell which has to go to division, we call it as mother cell. It divides to form two identical daughter cells, and the cells from that which are formed from that basic cell is known as daughter cells. So they have same number of chromosomes as the mother cell. It helps in growth and repair of the tissues in the organisms. So in the picture, it is shown that mitosis, there is one mother cell, in that chromosomes get divide, and each daughter cell will get the same number of the chromosome as that of the mother cell. But in meiosis, when a cell divides, it produces four new cells instead of two, which have half the number of chromosomes that of the mother cell. Basically, it occurs in specific cells of reproductive organs, which after fertilization give rise to offsprings. This type of meiosis is only occurs in sexual reproduction, where two parents are involved. So half chromosomes will get from one parent and half chromosome will get from the another parent. But in mitosis, it is asexual type of, it occurs in asexual reproduction, where the single cell just get divides to form the two daughter cells. With this, we completed our chapter. Go through the chapter, try to understand the topics and learn the question answers. Thank you.